really big moments you've had here. What was that like? And, you know, what is your mindset as you see them score? You know you're going to get the ball under 2 minutes left. What are you telling your teammates?
We got this. You know, that's really the big thing. It's like, hey, man, you know, just like practice, let's just go put it together. You know, we have different 2 minute scenarios every Thursday. We've been doing every week since pretty much fall camp. So, you know, we've done it before, and just instilling confidence. You know, we can do it. You know, we didn't have an ounce of doubt in our system, and we stepped on the field, you know, stepped on freely, not tense, just confident that we'd go score, and just had to go do it. So, yeah, just instilling confidence in the guys, and yeah.
Is there something freeing about no timeouts? It's just you guys out there?
I don't know if I would put it like that. But, you know, I think that there is just a freeing aspect of, hey, we have done this before. We've done it when we really needed it. You know, we had already done it that game. You know, we had already driven down and gotten a field goal when we needed it, and was a huge, big time field goal in that game. So, but then we had done it last year versus Kentucky. You know, we've had drives like this. We do it every week versus practice, kind of what I was saying. So when we do step on the field and we've chased those scenarios, you know, I feel like I get to step on the field, and you know, I love, and in those scenarios, I love watching NFL guys go do that. You know, there's a scenario a couple years ago when, you know, Josh Allen took the field with less than a minute left, went and scored, you know, game's over, 16 seconds left, Patrick Mahomes gets the ball with 16 seconds and drives down the field and goes and scores the game with a field goal. And it's never over till it's over. So I love watching guys above me that do it at really a high elite level, and I feel like I get to step on the field just with a calm and a presence that's just calm, cool, and collected and ready to go score. So.
That scenario in your hallway back at home?
Yeah, exactly.
You guys all said after the game that you guys all believed you could go out there and win it. There was every single guy on the sideline. And I believe you guys have that belief, and I believe that you have always thought, like, I can do this. But is there a different level because of the Kentucky game, because of some of these moments? Does it feel different now? Or maybe not even in yourself, but around you, the belief that has continued to grow and confidence on that sideline?
Absolutely. You know, I think that, you know, Coach Sweeney said it, and he's like, you know, I think 99.5% of the teams, if they are in our scenario on Saturday, they would have lost the game. Because they just, you know, what we have here, the heart and the belief in what we do, it's just really special. And the heart to go finish when it's not looking our way. You know, they had the whole momentum, they had everything going their way the whole second half. And we just, we were resilient, we persevered, and, you know, we just defied the odds, and that's just kind of what this team is. I think that's what a championship team is made of, and being able to finish in those close games is really special. So, yeah, I mean, just that kind of grit and that kind of just want to is definitely really special.
Okay, when you have that kind of drive at the end of the game, is it growing y'all's confidence that you can go win that kind of a game, or is it more just showing everybody else what you guys have already known?
Yeah, I think that whenever we are in that scenario, just confidence that we can, you know, that we can go win it, and we've done it before. And there's definitely just confidence that, hey, it's never over till it's over, and that's the truth. So just go finish the game and give everything you have till the very last play.
You mentioned how you guys do those two-minute scenarios every Thursday. Is that draw play something that you've worked on before in that specific scenario, and did you expect it to be the one that scores the touchdown?
No, I did not expect that to definitely score. You know, I mean, they're just playing a lot of two man. They were in the first half, and then a lot in the second one too. Just a lot of two man. So we kind of saw that, and Coach Riley had a great call. You know, I think it was second and four or something like that. So that's a great call, just stick draw. It's a great second and four call. You know, go get the first down, get a quick another play off if we get tackled, and but definitely go get all you can. And you know, I'm running down the field. I get it to the second level. It's wide open. We block it up perfectly. I get up to the second level. I see the safety coming at me. So I'm like, I gotta get out of bounds. You know, we don't have any time out, so I kind of take a right. Started going right out of bounds. TJ's blocking this guy, and then the guy peeled around, not letting me get out of bounds, and TJ just kind of kept him going, and then I just kind of reacted and just kind of went with it. But, you know, I mean, we do work those every Wednesday, and, you know, it's kind of different every week. Some it's, you know, hey, yeah, one timeout, you know, touchdown to win it. Two timeouts, field goal to win it. Or, you know, no timeouts, touchdown to win it. Minute and a half, let's go. I mean, we really work a lot of different scenarios that could really happen. And that preparation, I think, has helped me a ton. Just whenever we did get to those scenarios, you know, we're really ready for them and we know what to do. And, you know, Antonio and Jake on those two catches in the second half, you know, are straining to get out of bounds. You saw that in the first half too. They're straining to get out of bounds. We want that clock to stop. So that's just preparation and just the knowledge of the game. Those guys are vets in the game, and they know what to do, and they know how to play. So
y'all face a lot of press coverage the last three games. What do you think y'all learned just from that?
I mean, I think we got great receivers. You know, we've got dudes that can go win at a very high and elite level, and that's really exciting. So, you know, I love it. You know, I love that we got dudes out there that, you know, we've probably got six or seven guys that can really go play at a really high and elite level for us. So, you know, they will impress us or not. It's wherever they want. But, you know, I trust in the guys to go get open. So,
obviously, you trust your offensive line, but individually, Blake is flipping the left and Walker is going the right. Like, how do you reset and stay comfortable in that situation, knowing that it's not comfortable for them?
Yeah. As weird as it sounds, I try not to really think about it. I just really just trust them and go play on the back end, you know, and go deliver the football. So, you know, those guys are doing what they do at a very high level. And, you know, it's not like you got two freshmen that are having to switch positions. You got Blake Miller and Walker Parks that are moving. So those guys know what they're doing. I got trust in them, and I get to step on the field and not be hesitant and not feel like I have to get the ball out of my hands any faster and stuff. So, you know, I'm comfortable back there with them and got full trust in them.
You were sacked a season high five times against Pitt. Like, how did you not, I guess, get rattled when the pressure was so, like, immense against you on Saturday?
Yeah. You know, it was, you know, it was a different lineup up front. So that, you know, it's going to take a little bit to adjust to that. But I, you know, I took two sacks that could have thrown it away, at least two. So, you know, I'll take credit for those ones. And then, you know, they're a great rushing team. You know, you got to give props to them at the same time. They're blitzing six or seven guys almost every single play from every which way they possibly can. So you got to give props to them. And then, you know, we just persevered and kept pushing through and then, you know, went and won the game. So that's what matters.
You talked about trust with your guys, but what about your trust element with guys like Garrett Riley, somebody who's semi-new in this program, but two of y'all who have come in obviously with immense amount of football knowledge? What does that look like together? What is that as the season has progressed and as y'all continue to grow together?
Yeah, I mean, I have never once had any doubt in the play calling or, you know, been frustrated with the way that he's doing things one time. I've got all my chips on him because, you know, what he's doing is it's at a very elite level. And I see that throughout the week, and I love to watch the way he scouts a team and sees a team and just through another lens. You know, I'm trying my best to see, you know, and see a defense through certain ways, and then I'll look at it one way and he'll be like, yeah, that's great, but if we do this from another way, boom, this might pop it over. Like, you know, that's why they're paying him the big bucks. So I love watching him, but I got all my trust in him, and I love Coach Riley. I love getting to go to work with him every day. He makes, you know, what we do really fun. And just, you know, I love him, and I love love what he does at a very high elite level.
How grateful are you to be able to say, hey, I can come to work every single day and see this coach and trust him completely? How grateful and, you know, blessed are you to be able to work with a guy that you feel like you mesh with so well?
Yeah, super blessed. You know, I think there's a lot of coaches or a lot of players out there that, you know, especially if they weren't recruited by the guy, but even sometimes they are, they don't necessarily click super well with the coach that they have. And, you know, that's unfortunate at times. And just places that other guys at other schools that I know that, you know, might not like the guy that they have or whatever. But, it's definitely a huge blessing. I mean, we all love Coach Riley, and he's one of my favorite coaches I've ever had. So definitely a huge blessing.
Antonio Williams having a career day on Saturdays. Was there something that you were seeing early in the coverage? Just